Dear reader, this little book is designed to tell you everything you need to know to survive the holiday season, so you can guide your way past all the holiday trappings and get to the heart of what the season really means to each of us. It's to prove once and for all that Christmas isn't just about the gifts that you get and give, but about the joy and love in our hearts for our family and friends. It's about showing peace on earth and goodwill towards our fellow man.
Christmas is music and family in town. Christmas is Snoopy and Charlie Brown. It's anticipating that snow's gonna fall.
And praying for some place to park at the mall.
It's mom going crazy cause the turkey got burned.
It's saying thanks for some gifts you'll return.
Christmas is caroling kids at your door.
It's paper and ribbon on.
Chapter 1, The List. The key to starting the holidays off right is crafting the perfect letter to Santa.
Dear Santa, I'm not sure what I want for Christmas this year. Perhaps you should just send me your catalog. I don't think I'm gonna send that.
Dear Santa, that sounds kind of stuffy.
Perhaps something a little more casual would be better.
Okay, how about Dear Fatty? Dear Santa Claus, I know you are a busy man. I don't want to waste your time thinking about toys I might like. Make it easy on yourself. This year, just bring me money. Preferably tens and twenties. Hey, Santa Claus. Save all that sappy stuff for another holiday.
Chapter 2. But remember, dear reader, and you too, Lucy, the holidays aren't about getting the perfect gift, but giving the perfect gift. It is better to give than to receive.
Linus, do you believe in Santa?
I do, because the moment you stop believing in Santa Claus is the moment you start getting clothes for Christmas.
So I said to Schroeder, if you really liked me, you'd give me lots of Christmas presents.
And what did he say?
He said if you really liked me, you wouldn't expect presents. Either way, I end up not getting any presents.
Oh, my sweet Babu, I
don't want you to give me anything for Christmas this year.
Really? That's too bad. But I can understand how you feel. Cancel that order for the $10,000 necklace!
After the holidays are over and everything is quieted down, I'm gonna slug you! Last Christmas, nobody gave me what I wanted.
What did they give you?
Shoes, a green sweater, a bunch of stupid toys.
What were you expecting?
Real estate!
Well, it took me 6 weeks, but I finally figured it out. All in all, he gave her 22 turtle doves, 30 French hens, 36 calling birds, 40 gold rings, 42 geese a-laying, 42 swans a-swimming, 40 maids a-milking, 30 pipers piping, 30 ladies dancing, 22 lords a-leaping, 12 fiddlers fiddling, and 12 partridges and pear trees. Whew! He must have had quite the credit limit.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a wood stock in a pear tree. What kind of gift is that?
On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a Beethoven sonata.
And a wood stock in a pear tree. Why would someone give a bird in a fruit tree for Christmas?
On the third day of Christmas, my parents gave to me a blue security blanket.
Seriously, what must go through someone's mind when they pick such a thing?
On the fourth day of Christmas, Lucy gave to me psychiatric help. 5 cents, please. Psychiatric help, blue security blanket, Beethoven sonata.
It's simply the worst Christmas gift ever.
On the sixth day of Christmas, my teacher gave to me a rock.
A rock?
Well, a fruitcake.
Same thing. And a wood stock in a pear tree. I'd rather have that fruitcake.
On the seventh day of Christmas, Snoopy gave to me doctrine from a beagle.
Really crusty fruitcake.
5 cents, please.
Psychiatric help, blue security blanket,
Beethoven sonata.
And a wood stock in a pear tree. Where would you even buy such a thing?
On the eighth day of Christmas, my dear friend gave to me a chance to kick that football.
I'll trade you for the fruitcake.
On the ninth day of Christmas, Great Pumpkin gave to me lots of toys and candy.
A chance to kick that football.
Doctors from a beagle. A bunch of other stuff and a wood stock in a pear tree. It's the gift that keeps on giving.
On the tenth day of Christmas, my postman gave to me a letter from my pen pal.
Toys from the Great Pumpkin.
A chance to kick that football.
Doctors from a beagle.
Too much stuff to mention and a wood stock in a pear tree. I wonder if I could re-gift any of this stuff.
On the 11th day of Christmas, Santa gave to me a brand new baseball mitt.
A letter from my pen pal.
Toys from the Great Pumpkin.
Blah, 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 blah. And a wood stock in a pear tree. On the 12th day of Christmas, although it may seem strange, on the 12th day of Christmas, I'm going to exchange
a brand new baseball mitt,
a letter from my pen pal,
toys from the Great Pumpkin,
a chance to kick the football,
doctors,
a rock, I mean a fruitcake.
5 cents, please.
Psychiatric help, blue security blanket,
Beethoven sonata,
and a wood stock in a pear tree.
And always remember to save your receipts.
Yes, ma'am. I'd like to return something I bought here. It was a Christmas present for a girl, but he was too shy to give it to her. I was going to give it to a little red-haired girl in our class. You're her mom? You're her mom and you worked here? When we first saw you, we thought you were her older sister. Why did you tell her that? She's letting you return the present, isn't she?
Is it Christmas yet?
Not yet.
If Christmas comes and you don't tell me, I'm going to be so mad at you. Is it Halloween yet?
Halloween is over.
I am so mad at you.
Chapter 3, The Food. If you have failed to secure the perfect gift for your loved one, no need to be stressed. Remember, stressed is just desserts spelled backwards. Enjoy all the goodies the holidays have to offer.
Well, how do you like the hot chocolate I made for you?
It's terrible! It tastes like some warm water with brown crayons dipped in it.
You're right. I'll go put in another crayon.
Don't want tinsel, don't want bows, don't want Rudolph's shiny nose. I want sweet treats for Christmas. Cars and trees are dandy, but please bring on the candy. I want sweet treats for Christmas. Marshmallow cream on a hot fudge supreme. Sweet treats for Christmas. Later by the fire, with my heart's desire, chocolate kisses and mistletoe. We're planning quite a buffet, complete with a Christmas souffle. So please take our advice, sugar and spice is very nice. We're wishing you a sweet Christmas.
Chapter 4. Dear Reader, by now you have discovered that Christmas is many things that do not cost a dime. Yes, there are gifts and giving and goodies, but what is more important than anything is knowing that
Christmas is love.
Yes, Charlie Brown, Christmas is love.
Is it Christmas yet?
Yes, Sally, it's Christmas, and I got you a present.
What is it?
A calendar.
Aww. I love you, big brother.
Christmas is all of these fun things for sure.
Christmas is really, oh, so much more.
It's good news of hope for the whole world because
Christmas.
Joining us for A Peanut's Guide to Christmas. Let's show some holiday spirit for our dancing duo. Sally Brown, Linus Van Pelt, Lucy Van Pelt, Charlie Brown, and of course, Santa Snoopy.
Christmas.